Lisane Basquiat. I'm the co-administrator of the Jean-Michel Basquiat estate and Jean-Michel's younger sister.
Hi, I'm Shanine Heriveaux, and I am also co-administrator of the Jean-Michel Basquiat estate, and I am his youngest sister. We wanted to do this exhibition now because there had been a point where we were trying to figure out what was the next thing that we wanted to do after participating in quite a few other exhibitions and loaning works to other museums. And so we thought it would be a good idea to create something of our own. Our stepmother had suggested to us that we show the works that we've been having in our warehouse stored for over 30 years. And we thought that was a great idea, and that was something that we needed to show his fans. And so we started thinking that this would be the 2020 is when we ultimately decided that this would be a great time with all of the political things that were going on, George Floyd's killing and the pandemic, that would be a great time and opportunity to create this show and get moving. And it's been 19 months and we haven't looked back at this point.
We think it's really important that we tell the story of Jean-Michel from the perspective of his family, because we're the only ones that can really provide insight into Jean-Michel's journey and the context within which Jean-Michel was raised and the way that he entered into his adulthood. There are a lot of people who have spoken about Jean-Michel in the past, and that's all great because their perspectives are what they are. What's different about this is that it really does give people insight into who he was as a child, the family that he was brought up into, the fact that he is the son of a Haitian father and a Puerto Rican mother, and the fact that we grew up in Brooklyn, and some of the things that he got exposed to as a child. We think that those are really, really important, and we wanted to make sure that we shared those.
Our dad and our mom also encouraged us to be very proud of our heritage and to be proud of being Black in America. It was always very important for him to have us understand what that meant and to be proud in that, to not allow that to hold us back in any way, whether it was our presence in a room, our education. And so definitely my dad had an influence in that. And it's quite possible that Jean-Michel, you know, got that from him as well.
We wore the pride in being a Basquiat years before Basquiat became cool for the world. I think the idea of Black heroes is something that Jean-Michel cultivated through exposure to a lot of different things. I think that the idea of royalty, which is actually the name of one of the Soho galleries in the exhibition, the idea of royalty is really a reference to Jean-Michel's courage to really claim his royalty and to put a crown on himself, and for him to understand and tell the world that he knew that that's who he was. He did also, or we did as children, we got a lot of exposure to music and to art and to culture and to sports figures and to museums and that kind of thing. And so Jean-Michel did have quite a lot of exposure to Black royalty and to just the history of the world. And you can see that in his art. We recreated portions of our childhood home in Borham Hill, and the living room and the kitchen. And a couple of weeks ago, as we were managing the installation of those two rooms, it felt so real that we were like laying across the couch and sitting on the chairs, and 90%, maybe 95% of what's in those two rooms are actually things from our childhood home. The table, you know, the couch is spot on. It's not the same couch anymore, but it's certainly spot on.
Yeah. There's this really sense of warmth walking through that section that just brings a lot of great memories for me, and just the ability to bring me back to so many meals that we had at that kitchen table, brunches, Christmas dinners, Thanksgiving dinners. So it's a beautiful element of the exhibition that I hope people enjoy. The biggest challenge, I think, was including everything, you know. So we have, it was tough to recreate kind of when you first enter and there's kind of a kitchen area, and it was difficult to translate that and include. We have this long table that we opted not to actually put into the exhibition because we wanted to make sure that everyone was able to capture all of the ephemera, the items that he brought back from his trip to the Ivory Coast, and you know, other things that he purchased while he was traveling.
I love the studio space because I can see Jean-Michel there, and that was really what inspired us and informed the way that we pulled it together, going all the way down to, you know, the music and the videos and you know, a couple of bottles of wine, and you know, the way that he would just move throughout his studio and with such intention and purposefulness.
The history that Jean-Michel exposed to both of us from some of the words and the subjects that he used were fascinating to kind of understand and kind of see what was in his mind at the time. And all of the books that are in his studio were really research material for him. It is so prevalent in the work and so obvious in the work that he poured through those books and really thought about what it was that he wanted to put in his drawings and his paintings. Very purposeful.
Jean-Michel was a black man in the city, in New York City, in the 70s. And he had a really hard time catching a cab in the city, as many black men did. So much so that he would often have to have his friends who were not of color hail a cab for him, so he can just, you know, hop into one. And he also rode his bike for exercise because he just liked to ride a bike. We all did when we were younger. And so we included one of his bicycles in the exhibition. It's sitting in front of a facade of his Great Jones studio. And so we chose to include it because, again, our goal really is to share as much as we can about Jean-Michel and really bring context to who Jean-Michel was and to the way that he was experiencing the world in parallel with his trajectory within the art world and within his career as an artist.
When the paintings were installed, I had the opportunity of going with Jean-Michel to see it. It was very brief. So there were certain parts of it that I remember, but we also did a lot of research and looked online to, you know, to get some ideas of exactly what the blueprint was. And we have an incredible team that were able to find, you know, some of the original footage of the films that were shown and the videos that were shown in the Palladium. And also we were able to find photographs. I believe the video footage comes all the way from Australia. And of course, you know, the best part of the room are the two paintings. You know, we've had this in our family since they were taken down from the Michael Todd room. So, you know, these are what really pull the room together. And everything else is just a replica of what was in the room.
It was really important for us also that this exhibition be both an immersive experience and also a celebration of Jean-Michel. We really have done this to, this is our way of paying homage to our brother. And part of that is really acknowledging the fact that he loved to party and he loved music. And so, you know, after going through the journey through the other rooms, we thought it was really important that we end the journey within the exhibition with just a real shout out to celebrating Jean-Michel in this space. Typically there's music playing in here, and it's really like a party atmosphere, a very celebratory atmosphere. And that's what most people say after walking into this room, that they feel this sense of celebration and party and fun. Our dad did a phenomenal job of protecting Jean-Michel's legacy and ensuring that his art was taken seriously. He passed away in 2013, and with his passing, Jeanine and I became responsible for the administration of Jean-Michel's estate. And it means the world to us. He's our brother, and it's family, and that is very important to all of us as a family. What it's meant to us since 2013, at least, is really an opportunity for me to feel like we three are doing something together. You know, our parents lost a son 33 years ago. We lost a brother. And there is a hole in the family because of that. And so I feel very grateful that we have the ability to continue to exist with Jean-Michel in this way. I really wish he was here. And that we could experience his life with him, but also I'm very grateful that we have the ability to do this. Jeanine and I had different lives and we're doing other things. We've led very private lives over the last few decades. Our dad wanted us to have the opportunity to build our lives before taking on this responsibility. And it's fun. It's a lot of work. We are continuing to manage the estate in parallel with putting this exhibition together, which is a pretty hefty feat. but it feels really good, and I feel very grateful to be able to do this.
What legacy means for me is to pass this on, this gift that we can pass on to our children and grandchildren. It is an opportunity to show them a piece of their uncle that they did not meet. There's only one nephew that actually knew him and met him before he passed away. And so it is our way to show them the possibility, bring out all of the family ephemera and photos, and show them the emotional aspect and the love that we have. And hopefully they can take that and carry that out to future generations.